Hi everybody, this is Atiq Ahmed. I welcome all of you to my YouTube channel Engineering Drive. Today I am going to discuss one of the topic of C programming, preprocessor directives of C. They are popularly known as C preprocessor directives. Directives are nothing but which will give direction, and preprocessor are nothing but something in which processing is done in advance or in before. Okay, so this is the idea we got whenever we see this title. And it is one of the topics of C programming which will be ignored generally. Many people ignore this topic, but in many competitive exams, the questions will appear from this concept only. Hardly you will get 2 to 3 questions guaranteed from this concept in most of the competitive exams. So because of that, let us have a clear understanding of what are C preprocessor directives. And popularly there are 2 C preprocessor directives that will come across. One is hash include, this is one preprocessor directive, and the second one is hash define. Okay, hash include and hash define, there will be many more, but these are the most popularly preprocessor directives that will be used in our programs. In most of our C programs, we will come across with this preprocessor directives only. So because of that reason, we are going to understand the use and importance of them. Okay, let us first concentrate on what is hash include and what is the use of this preprocessor directive. You know that in every C program, we will make use of 2 header files. We will write them at the top of the program, such as hash include less than stdio.h greater than, and we will make use of one more header file, hash include less than conio.h greater than. So these are the 2 header files we will use generally in our program. Whether you observed any time why we will use these header files, what is the main purpose of using these header files? Including is nothing but adding, including conio.h, stdio.h. stdio stands for standard input output, conio stands for console input output. If whenever you are using hash include less than stdio.h in the program, you are telling to the computer in advance, before you are, you know, your program will begin from here, that is void main, your program will begin here from main to this getch. This is your program. Still your program has not started, before that only you are writing these header files. That's why we call them as preprocessor directives. So what you are telling to your computer, that you want to include, what you want to include, all the functions related to the header file stdio.h, standard input output. So which functions will come under the category of stdio, standard input output? Like already we know that in our main we will make use of printf function, we will make use of scanf function. So these are the best examples of these 2 functions which comes under the category of which library? Stdio. So you are telling to your computer that please include the functions which are present in which header file? Stdio.h header file. Example, printf, scanf. Printf is the output function, scanf is the input function. So it will, you are telling to your computer in advance, you are telling to the C compiler in advance. Similarly, hash include less than conio.h. Conio stands for console input output. Console refers to monitor or display or screen, which means you are telling to your C compiler that include all the functions which are present in conio.h header file. You know which functions are available in conio.h header file? Best examples are clr, scr function. Okay, this function, similarly getch function, these are the 2 functions that are available in which header files? Conio.h header file. So let us say in your editor, if you missed these 2 header files, then you are not going to inform to the compiler that you are going to make use of all these functions. So there is a chance that you may get any warnings or errors. To overcome that problem, what you need to do? Compulsory you make use of hash include keyword and include all the functions related to those header files. Similarly, in some cases, you want to make use of one more function, sqrt, square root function. Whenever you want to use this type of square root mathematical function, there is one more header file you can use in your C program. The name of the header file is hash include less than math dot h greater than. So you are telling to the C compiler that include all the mathematical relation related functions which are present in which header file, math dot h header file. So if you write this this particular line that is hash include less than math dot h greater than, then of course not only sqrt, tan theta, sin theta, cos theta, all those functions you can use in your program without any errors. Okay, hopefully it has been clear to you. So this is the use of hash include keyword. Now there is one more keyword that is defined in our C programs, and we will use it very rarely, but it is having lot of significance. What is the name of the second preprocessor directive? The name of the second preprocessor directive, hash defined. What is the work of this hash defined? Means if I want to change the names of some words in my program, then I can make use of this preprocessor directive hash defined. How, sir? Can you give an example? Let us see. Suppose I want to write one program with my own name. See the modifications I am doing. What I am going to do is Atiq space Ahmed parenthesis opening brace. So what I am going to do? Integer a is equal to 10, clear. Okay, next output next end close. Now what I have done, you can see that it is not a C program. You may be directly, if you see, you will say, sir, entire program is wrong. Why? Means sir, how you can write your own name? Actually, you know that, but you got one idea that instead of wide, what I have written here, Atiq. Instead of main, I have written Ahmed. Instead of int data type, I have written integer. Instead of CLR, SCR function, I have written which function? My own name, clear. Instead of printf, I have written output, and instead of getch, I have written end. So it is my dream that I want to write my own program now with my own words. But C does not permit you to write like this directly, because if you write program like this and if you try to compile the program, you will get one major error that it is undefined words you have used in the program. So your program will not be compiled successfully at all. It will show error. Then what to do now? So C language provides one flexibility, one preprocessor directive. Preprocessor directive means right before the program always. Okay, so write the preprocessor directive hash define. Okay, and use, suppose I want to use this duplicate word. What is that? My name Atiq. I want to use, instead of which word? I want to use this instead of white. Has defined duplicate name space original name. I want to use Atiq instead of white. You are telling to the compiler. Similarly, next hash define, I want to use Ahmed instead of which keyword? Main. Very good. Like this. Okay. Similarly, whatever the keywords you have used, duplicate names, write the duplicate name space write original name, write duplicate name write original name, write duplicate name write original name. Like that, how many hash defines you should use in the program is 1 2 3 4 5 6. 6 times you need to use hash define, 6 times you write duplicate name, 6 times you write original name. The syntax of using this hash define keyword is hash defined space duplicate name space original name. Like that, if you use, you can change the name of any words in the program. So this is the second preprocessor directive. Preprocessor directives means they will come before main only. Above main only, you should make use of this preprocessor directives. So these are the two preprocessor directives that I thought to discuss with you, and they are very important, and surely many questions may come from this concept in competitive exams. So try to prepare it in a simple and efficient way. Okay, so what are the two preprocessor directives we have discussed? One is hash include, another one is hash define. So with this, Let me close my today's session of video. If you have not subscribed my channel, subscribe it and share it to your friends so that whoever are studying this type of subjects, easily they can learn from their home without any major problems. So see you soon in my next video. Take care. Allah Hafiz.